bless your name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This day is very important.
Kula malanga kubalekile.
To hold unto the anointing.
Ukubambelela kulo ugcobo.
The spirit of the living God.
Nomoya kaNkulunkulu.
And also his power.
Namandla wakhe.
I was so moved when my friend told me about the theme of this conference. Anointed, but still relevant.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Anointed.
Sorry.
Anointed, but still relevant.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm going to read.
Zofunda.
First Samuel.
Samuel Okala.
Chapter 15.
Safiro says 15.
Verse 1.
Verse Okala.
To verse 22.
We are going 22.
Samuel said to Saul, I'm the one the Lord sent to anoint you king over his people, Israel. So listen now to the message from the Lord. This is what the Lord Almighty says. I will punish the Amalekites for what they did to Israel when they waylaid them as they came up from Egypt. Now go, attack the Amalekites and totally destroy everything that belongs to them. Do not spare them. Put them to death, men and women, children and infants, cattle and sheep, camels and donkeys. Jesus. So Saul summoned the men and mustered them at the Telaim, 200,000 foot soldiers and 10,000 men from Judea. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's go, let's keep and go to that verse that says, I am grieved that I've made Saul king, because he has turned away from me and has not carried out my instructions. Samuel was troubled, and he cried out to the Lord all the night. Early in the morning, Samuel got up and went to meet Saul. But he was told, Saul has gone to Carmel. There he set up a monument in his own honor.
Sure.
Look at that. Note that.
Sure.
up there, he has disobeyed the Lord.
Yeah.
Then he came out to make a monument for himself, not for God. Anointed, but still remaining relevant.
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Anointed. But still remaining relevant.
Amen.
And we'll continue reading.
Yeah.
When we look at this scripture,
must beggar less fund.
Or before we come to that, I'm going to talk about two young men. Saul and David.
Saul and David.
Though we are told about them in the Bible as, you know, elderly men, but they were anointed by God whilst they were young.
Yeah.
Get me well. They were anointed by God whilst they were young.
Yeah.
Reveal this team of yours, Pastor.
Yeah.
I want to talk about these two brothers. Saul and David.
Saul not David.
Yeah.
The Bible says, when Moses, during the time of Moses, the Israelites were led by leaders.
Yeah.
Then there came a period when God changed the strategy. Because our God is a God of strategy. Our God is not only God of yesterday. He does not only do things according to the way he did them yesterday. But he looks at the situation now. What is happening now?
Then
he changed the strategy. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He saw that it was no longer okay for the Israelites to be led by the leaders. Then they had to be led by the kings.
Then go for it,
they had to be led by the kings. And the first king to be anointed was Saul. Hallelujah.
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 Amen.
Listen to this verse, to this stanza when it starts. Someone said, I'm the one who anointed you. Or the one who was instructed by God to anoint you. Anointed but remain relevant. Saul was anointed for a purpose. When God anoints a person, he anoints a person for a purpose. He does not anoint a person for the sake that you are known or you know yourself that you are anointed. But God anoints you for a purpose. God wants to do something about you. Because God does not play with your
mind.
God does not play with your
mind.
Because the anointing is his power. The anointing is himself. The anointing is the ability of God. The anointing is the ability of God, church. Power of God. You have got the ability of God. Satan, Lord demon,
is able to stand before you. When you are anointed, because you have got God with us.
The Bible here puts it quite clearly. Samuel says,
Samuel,
God anointed you so that you can revenge. So that you can pay revenge for the Israelites. He wanted him to destroy the Amalekites. That was the assignment. You know, when you're a child of God, you must reach a point where you know why have you been called by God. If you don't know why you are in the house of the Lord, you are going to do havoc. You are going to be troublesome. I must tell you, troublesome people in the church, those who don't know why they are in the church, why are they in the Lord? Why are they saved? If you know why you are saved, you are caught up in the church. You are complete in the church. To destroy the Amalekites. I'm reminded now of Samson. The Bible says, when it came for Samson to get a wife, he went to the nation, to the
heathen,
to get a wife.
Are you fast?
But Father, let us stick on the word.
It is stylized with
you cannot get me wrong. You know,
Samson
was away that he was not supposed to get a wife from the
heathen.
Unbelievers. Now Samson was
saying light has not mixed with
darkness. What he grew up with. That you cannot grow and get married to an unsaved lady.
But
we saw
Samson
taking a woman from the Philistines.
Worst
of all, from the Philistines. The Philistines were the enemies of Israel.
They were
the primary enemies of the Israelites.
And then Jonah sees us.
children of Israel,
abantwana bakaIsrayeli,
were warned about the Israelites. Yes, about each about Philistines.
Have nothing to do with the Philistines. They took our ark of the Ark of
Covenant.
They fought us. They prevented us from entering the Canaan. It was very difficult for us Israelites to possess Canaan
because of the Philistines. There he is.
He's singing,
you know, woman. Who can give, I'm also a teacher, who can give an answer to this question? I'm going to ask.
Whose
fault? Was that Samson, you know, got a wife from the Philistines? Was it
Samson?
Let me give you the answer.
It was not the fault of Samson.
There was still Samson.
That was predestined.
That
was well orchestrated. That was well planned by the heavens. When God is about to do something,
there
are some of the things he plans. You can ask a question as how do you marry faith? When she found herself pregnant, when she was about to get married, I'm sure the ladies of the area and the people of the area were gossiping about her. Look at them now. They're saying. Look at them now. What is happening? Look at him now. He's a failure. And yet he says, he's saved.
Open the curtain.
Amen.
Bible, get me. Go up with me, please. Change.
Amen.
I'm not saying, what you think I'm sick?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. There are some of the things that when God is about to work, you know, he works things in a very complicated way. And the bad boy, this needed somebody who dwells in the spirit. Somebody who knows the thoughts of the Lord.
You
know what God thinks. Why are the things happening like this? If you don't know, go and ask God before you speak.
Before you speak.
Was it Samson got married to Delilah.
Samson was shot, not Delilah.
So that God could pay revenge.
To
fight the
Philistines.
All right. Get more young people. I'm not saying go and get married to an unsaved
people.
This man,
Lelota,
Saul, has got the assignment. He was specifically anointed for that man.
Why can't tell we Lelota?
You can detect a lot of things.
Begging sister, is it a need?
Appealing to his needs.
Can detect a lot of things.
But
God,
look at the thief.
Bega eyona yonando.
Uthixo ufuna kuyini?
What does God want you to do?
Why is God called you?
Ukubizele ini?
Why is God anointed you?
Ukugqobele ini?
You know, there's a saying by Jesus one time.
Kunesisho esashiwo uJesu.
When his apostles were showing him the temple of Herod.
Abapostile bebebonisa ithempeli lika Herod.
The Bible says it was well built.
Lithi iBhayibheli beyakhiwe kahle.
Stone over the stone.
Itse phezwelinye.
They said, look at here, Rabbi.
But bona la kuka.
Look at this beautiful temple.
Bona sisakhiwe sisihle kangaka.
Then Jesus immediately ascended.
Thoma ngoko uJesu wehla
and prophesied. And then look here. Upon the stone that you see that have been used to build this temple, no stone will be left on top of the other. Jesus was prophesying and continues to say, oh
Jerusalem,
if you knew your time of your visitation, you might be sensitive as umzalwane to your time of your visitation to God.
So far I said, oh, good.
Each and every Christian
umzalwane
has a time of his or her visitation. Make sure that you don't miss that time. Make sure that you don't miss your time of visitation. Your time of blessings. Your time of favor. Your time of favor. Your time of abundance. Yeah, your time of
everything.
Each and every person has a time of visitation by God. Make sure that you don't miss that time. Make sure. Anointed what? But relevant. Let's come back to your topic, Pastor.
As well as your way.
This man, my top apostle.
Lendo the apostle.
You know, he wanted
Ebefuna
to be relevant to people.
Ebefuna ufaneleka ebantu.
At the expense.
Nge expense.
Of being relevant to God.
Yokuba relevant kuThixo.
That is why the Bible says.
Ungako iBhayibhile ithi.
You know, here the instruction is very clear.
Sure. The instruction is
very well tabulated.
Yeah.
Go and destroy the Amalekites. Hear them.
Yeah. Destroy.
You know, it doesn't even end there.
Yeah.
They are disintegrated. Disintegrated.
Yeah.
Kill the women. Kill the man. Kill the
intent.
Kill their belongings. That's a mission.
Yeah.
That's what he was anointed for.
Now you don't go to hell.
Sure. You know what?
Yazin.
You need to be very careful. Make sure. That we are relevant to God.
So would you be relevant to God?
Than to be relevant to people.
Kuno ba ube relevant ebantwini.
What do you mean, Bishop?
Shuthini manje, Bishop?
You say we must not be relevant to people?
Shuthi singabikho relevant ebantwini.
I don't mean that.
Angishongo kanjalo.
We are preaching to people.
Sishumayele ebantwini.
We are calling them to Christ.
Sibabizele yeSwini.
What is the logic here? What is the logic here? When you are relevant to God first, then you will become relevant to the people who want to be relevant to God. When you become relevant first to God, then you will become relevant to people who want to be relevant to God. Because not all the people want to be relevant to God.
ufanele ka uNkulunkulu.
Some are even deployed.
Abanye bathunyise.
You never satisfy all of them.
Because
they are not after what you have.
Ngoba balandele lento iphethe.
Moses did a great mistake.
Moses went a mistake enkulu kakhulu.
You know, my spiritual revelation can disappoint.
Indlela emoya ebonisa ngayo izinto ningasho indlela ibona ngayo.
When I sort of analyze.
Mangaba ngihlalutya.
As why Moses did not get into Canaan.
Kuba yinto yonenza Moses angangeni eCanaan.
It's because Moses at some point wanted to be relevant.
Ingoba Moses wafuna ukufaneleke ebantwini.
Why am I saying this?
Yini indaba ngisho lezo?
When Moses used to ascend the mountain.
Moses mangabe egibela intaba.
To look to face God face to face.
Aba ayobhekana noNkulunkulu ubuso nobuso.
I like this. You know, as he was facing God,
talking to God face to face,
khuluma noNkulunkulu ubuso nobuso, then the glory of God,
then inkazimulo kaNkulunkulu,
was transferred to Moses.
Shayidlula kuNkulunkulu uye kuMoses.
I don't get it. I'm saying when Moses was facing God, then the glory of God was transferred to him. When he descended the mountain, he will come glorious. And the people couldn't look at him. Because the glory of God was troublesome to them. Then Moses did a great mistake of taking the veil. Coming to the level of the people.
As many saban.
It was not a mistake.
Mistake.
That God was making his face to be glorious. God wanted to affect the people through him. God wanted the people to be like him. Then Moses did a great mistake of putting the veil instead of facing the people. They could be changed. You want to be glorious. When God wants you to change the people, he anoints a person. But sometimes one person take one person from a family, save one person in a family, then he knows quite well he's going to affect the whole family. So you must know what you are saying. And God gave him if you are from an unsaved family, God is still going to them. This is why you're supposed to be very careful. Be careful before them. Because God is going to affect them too. God is going to use you for your father to be saved. For your mother to be saved. For your brother to be saved. For your sister to be saved. Hallelujah. You anointed what? What? Anointed what? You watch food. Can I still preach? Can I still preach?
Hallelujah.
Can I still preach? Can I still preach?
Yes.
Can I still preach?
Yes.
Don't pull to the fake. Don't pull to the fake. Call me. You know these things that you see. That are being done in these days. Yay, the faith. Come as you are. Go to the people with your clothes.
All to the people of Gideon 90. Speak it away. Speak it away. Don't be moved by the number. Even if you are alone, God is ready to change multitudes. Using you.
You know, we are living in the days where people want to be, you know, accepted.
Abantu bafuna ukwamkeleka.
Bafuna
ukubonwa.
They want to be smart.
Bafuna ukubonwa.
Hallelujah. They want to be smart. They want to be relevant to people.
Bafuna ukwamkeleka ebantwini.
And yet be relevant to God. That was the condition with this man. God says, destroy the Amalekites. The time has come.
But ulala Amalekites is cast for you.
Can I say this?
Etigishono.
Oh God, the God of mercy.
Oh Mulungulu, we see her. He is long suffering. He keeps quiet. While things are happening anyhow, they can think that people agree with them. Keep quiet while the children are being persecuted.
But when they persecute you,
then
God keeps quiet. You can imagine as how, you know, the two boys in the pillar, I mean in the pool of fire, were feeling. They were sustained by faith.
I did not call.
Because faith is able to sustain you. Then faith sustains.
You
say, I know what I know. I know who I
serve.
I serve the mighty God. I serve God Almighty. When all the people are away from you, when all the people are speaking things, saying things about you, but you remain saying, I know. I know! I know what I know! That's what was said by these two boys. In the pool of fire, when Nebuchadnezzar asked them, how do you think we save you from this fire? Then the boys said, we know our God! We know the word he says! Greater than fire, he is the consuming fire, and make of his ministers the flames of fire. Hey, our God is above the situation of the bushes. As he says,
Unamanda.
Oh, yes.
Oh,
yes.
My God.
People will think,
then
God agrees.
Then God keeps quiet.
It's
not moved, my
brother. Then we panic so much. God doesn't panic.
You know why?
Because
he knows himself.
Because we are Zazien.
He knows his power. He knows his strength.
What's the amount of
what? He knows what he has.
What's the channel?
I know.
Hey!
Then he just keeps quiet.
Somebody when he sings, says, even if
you can recall. Hey, no matter who.
Even if he's quiet.
God, you bend you now. It's just a matter of time. It's just a matter of time.
But
he's rigid.
Yes, sir.
Keep quiet.
Yatula.
Yeah, there is some point to say, Bishop, he's quiet. You mean even with me? He's so quiet. I'm too a rough time. But he's quiet. He's quiet. He's quiet.
Uthule.
You know what?
Yazini.
He's you know, he's waiting for his right time.
Ulindele isikhathi sakhe kuyiso.
God does things at the right time.
Unkulunkulu wenza izinto ngesikhathi ekusiyiso.
There is the timing of God.
Unexesha kuNkulunkulu.
That is why you need to detect.
Kungakumele uthubeke.
You need to be spiritual enough to discern.
Kumele ujonge kahle ngokamoya.
The time of God.
Ixesha likaThixo.
Wait upon God.
Lindela uThixo.
Those who wait upon the Lord.
Abalindela kuThixo.
Will mount mountains like this.
Bazoshukumisa intaba.
And fly without getting weary.
Babhabhe bangakhathali.
Because they know their God.
Ngoba bayamazi.
They know the time of their, the timing of their call.
Bayazazi isikhathi sikaNkulunkulu wabo. Avela thule.
Then his time comes.
Mabe isikhathi sifika.
His time comes. Then it comes. You know, it came for, you know, for Pharaoh.
Ya figelu Pharaoh.
He thought it was well.
Ebecabanga ukuthi yonke into ikahle.
But to shine fire from Israel.
Why he thought he was the main man in Israel. Doing what he wants and taking place. And the people of promise.
Hey, the highly favored people.
Abantu abakhethiwe.
You know, abantu abantu besethembiso.
People of promise. He was putting them as lambs.
You know, treating them worse than animals.
And then treated them as
lambs. The children of Abraham. The children of Isaac. The one of the blessings. When the highly favored one is touched by the devil,
the strings of Satan,
the Lord waits.
While
he's waiting,
yes, indeed.
He's collecting his arms, he's collecting his weapons, because when he responds, when God attacks, when God attacks, no one will say no. This is why he says,
you know what?
Anyone who touches you,
no matter what you do,
the apple of my eye. Because you are highly favored. Your favor of the Lord is upon you. You were known before the foundation of this world. God predestined you. You are not saved for a mistake. It is not a coincidence that you are saved. It is not a coincidence that you are saved.
Oh Jesus.
Do you know? Chosen.
Ketiwe.
Chosen.
Ketiwe.
Hallelujah.
Oh yeah.
Come back. Anointed. But still relevant. This man,
the daughter,
failed God.
Yashuleka, yashule uNkulunkulu.
Failed the mission.
Yashuleka injongo yayo.
Bantabasha.
Young people,
please, Bajabacha.
Young people,
let us not fail the mission.
Sing a flag of between.
We are living in a very precarious time.
I
was saying to my pastors there when we were chatting with pastors. The body of Christ is under siege.
Umzimba kaNkulunkulu usenkingeni.
Is under attack. From the powers of darkness. You know what? God right now. Right in nowadays. God is looking for some people to anoint. To show his power. God is looking for young people. Mind you, when I started my sermon, I said, Saul and David were anointed whilst they were young. It's not that you cannot be anointed when you're old. But God anointed Saul and David whilst they were young. Why?
In
Indaba.
They had a long distance.
Baye baba nebanga elide.
They still had a long distance to travel.
Babese nebanga elide abazohamba.
God was still going to use them.
UNkulunkulu ebesazobasebenzisa.
For a long period.
For isikhathi eside.
Because they were young.
Ngoba babebancane.
You know, let me tell you this.
Tell you tell no.
They are men of God and women of God.
Amadoda namadoda nabo mama kaNkulunkulu.
That were used by God.
Abasetshenziswa
uNkulunkulu. Get me to get this word leaders.
Izwi kahle lento bakhokheli.
But because of the lack of the revelation of the thing of God.
Ngoba bengekho isikhilelo sikaNkulunkulu.
At their elderly age.
Bahamba noNkulunkulu ebudaleni babo.
As a result, what God wanted to do about them could not be finished.
And izinto abefuna ukuzenza ngabo zange ayiqede.
Their flesh became tired.
Inyama yakhathala.
Because at a certain point,
ngoba kuhamba kufika isikhathi,
the flesh becomes tired.
Inyama ikhathala.
This is the dust.
Umhlabathi lo.
This is the dust. At a certain point,
it
becomes tired. You know what happens after that?
Yes,
he knows. You know what happens after that? But when God starts with the young people, still a long way to go. But it becomes unfortunate when a young person fails
God.
Become irrelevant. No. It becomes irrelevant. I'm moving my hands with him. It becomes irrelevant.
Yeah, I'm irrelevant.
Yeah.
Yeah. Amen.
Yeah. Now this man, he has disobeyed God. But still,
God,
he took the strength
what
that he was supposed to use to fulfill the plan of God. And he built his monument. He built his name in other ways. These days, young people, we're facing a challenge as the body of Christ.
Sibhekene nomsebenzi onzima.
There are a lot of things that are happening. People want to exalt themselves instead of exalting Christ.
Don't
get
it.
That's the meaning of building monuments. You know, more than revealing Jesus died
on
the cross. That is why today, you know, I used to say my apostle, you know, with the Africans. We Africans.
Africa.
We usually don't make things to bow before them.
But
that does not mean that you are not involved.
That doesn't mean we are not involved in witchcraft or occultism. In worshipping idols.
Yes, worshipping idols. You know how to worship idols?
How it was to misunderstand it.
You know, we take some board.
Touch moon.
And the unfortunate part.
And if they are
found that
person.
Has been used by God.
Who said that is unkulunkulu?
There are two things, my apostle.
Zimbili izinto.
That happens. That we're facing. As no yenzenzeke
esenzeka manje.
Yokuqala. Careful of that. I know that God is still going to make me famous.
Okay. Ngiyazi ukuthi uNkulunkulu sazokuphakamisa.
God is still going to do miraculous works.
uNkulunkulu sazokwenza into
enkulu. I'm saved by faith.
Ngiyamukela ngokholo.
But I'm very careful.
God, you are careful
not to find people worshiping me.
What you are about to bother to me.
What you have faced now.
In the beginning of your mind.
We have got gods that are walking.
Sinonkulunkulu abahambayo.
We have got God that talks.
Sinonkulunkulu abakhulumayo.
We have got
God, you know, that are in flesh.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He built a monument.
Azakele.
He built a monument.
Azakele.
Instead of destroying the Amalekites. As instructed by God. Let's go down so that you can pray. Let's go down so that there's where I want us to go. Just read somebody from verse 20.
From the verse 20.
Oh my God. You know what God says? Amen. God says, I'm grieved. I'm grieved. I'm troubled that I've anointed so. Because he has become irrelevant now. He's disobeying me. Be very careful of disobeying God.
And
God is about to work.
When
his time has come to work.
When his time has
break somebody. Still chapter 15.
Yes. I then obeyed the Lord. Then Saul replied, I went out as he told me to, brought back King Agag and killed all the Amalekites.
Continue. Go to verse 22.
But my men did not kill the best sheep and cattle that they did capture. Instead, they brought them here.
And hey, listen here. Can I say something here before we go? He was the one who was given the instruction.
Not the people.
There are people who come out of what has been said by the Lord because of other people. God will not hold those people that you point fingers at accountable. But you will be the one to be held accountable. Because he gave you instruction. Not the other people. They are the ones. They are the ones who messed up. Shifting the blame
all the time.
You find the mess in the church.
Somebody causes
a mess in the church. Then you find
it's
the first one to go to the pastor.
Yeah,
pointing fingers at others.
And
when you sit down as a pastor, you scrutinize. You find that he or she is the one. But he's shifting the blame. We've got a problem. Let me speak it.
Yes, yes.
We've got cracks in the body of Christ. Yeah.
You
are fighting each other. You find that the devil now has got no stress anymore. Of looking for people to work for him.
Just
use his
tools
that are in the church. Why? It should not be like this. Hello, brothers and sisters. Be your brother's keeper.
Don't surrender her to the devil. Don't surrender him to the devil. Comfort him. Empower him. Even if he looks rich.
Don't surrender
him to the devil.
Tomorrow you're going to meet him. This is the soldier. That now his head does not change that he's the child of God. He still belongs to the family. He belongs to the Rainbow Family Church. He belongs here. He belongs here. He belongs here. He belongs here. Number 9. You must be on the ground. You must be calling. Because he was ready to fight. He was ready to fight. He was ready to fight. Those who don't get hurt are those who don't get to the battle. Those who go to the battle, they get hurt. Those who need in the sun. Those who need in the sun.
Anointed but relevant. Anointed but relevant. Make sure that you're relevant. You become relevant when you obey God. You become relevant when you obey God. Obey God. Hold up to the word. Fall on the word. Fall on the word. Difficult. He doesn't find it difficult. Because they're those. You know they're the ancients. You know they're the deployed. You know to help him. Then stop that. Then what's the car?
He belongs home.
What's the car, Lord?
He belongs home.
Then what's the car? Look at your neighbor.
Look at your neighbor.
We are going to heaven.
happen. We are going to happen. Let us go to happen. Let us go to happen. Even if you are weak, even if you are weak, let us go to happen. Let us go to happen. My God.
Thank you. It was so powerful.
Nice.
We were blessed. Oh my God, we enjoyed it.
And we saw some guys dancing there. We saw another guy big us to sit down and do it. Not understand. I see
how they saw
on the head. This people men were dancing. You know, it was great.
We did enjoy it. It's Shona dances, by the way. He came up with him. So you saw Shona guy, Zimbabwe dances. So you think he can dance from Zimbabwe?
So he dances with power, you know.
And there's the gun one.
I don't understand the name for this.
Yeah.
He wants to run you.
I'm going to